Japanese armor is among the most beautiful and colorful in the world. The sophisticated techniques used to create the armors and the rare materials used to forge them included iron, leather, precious metals, dyed textiles, and silk. Historically, we have evidence of two different types of body armor that existed prior to the 8th century AD in Japan. The first type of armor, called tanko, was assembled from iron plates and have been unearthed from the tombs of the Kofun period between the 3rd and 7th century AD. The second type of armor, called keiko, is a flexible leather material and is created using iron sheets, known as seinen. The keiko tied together with cords to create sheets on which the armor was based on. Two types of kabuto, or helmets, have been found from this same period as well. The first type of helmet, called shokutsuki kabuto, has a sharp projection at the front of the head and looks like the bow of a ship. The second type of helmet, called mabisashi suki kabuto, has the shape of a quarter moon at the brim of the helmet. During the Han period from 784 AD to 1185 AD, the Japanese samurai armors were based on the keiko model. From 1336 to 1392, also known as the Nanbokucho period, to the Muromachi period that ranged from 1392 to 1573, wars were fought using swords and on-staff weapons with attached blades. Japanese warfare evolved again during the 16th century from being battles between a few hundred combatants to thousands of fighters. During this time, the yari, a spear used to cut and thrust, was utilized frequently. In the mid-16th century, firearms became crucial players in warfare, especially during the Tensho era from 1573 to 1592. Firearms were also used in the 1600s during the Battle of Sekigahara and the Siege of Osaka Castle in 1614. Both of these victories helped Tokugawa Ieyasu gain and maintain power in the early 1600s. Older components of armor were often used to create suits. The recycled armor, or shikashi mono, were inexpensive helmets, also made using three iron plates, one on each side and one in the center. Elaborate types of decorative helmets called kawari kabuto became popular as well. The kawari kabuto also had animal hair, 3D mountainous landscapes, and other objects attached to it. The hineno nari were helmets also made during the 1600s that had a neck guard that is longer on the back than on the sides. The decorations on the samurai's helmets was seen as a symbolic representation on the battlefield. Seinen are the small leather and or iron plates that were used as the building blocks in traditional Japanese samurai armors. Each seinen is punctured with holes that are then threaded together to create horizontal rolls that overlap, creating the traditional samurai armor
we recognize until today. The term seinen would evolve into the word kozen, meaning small scale. The scales were at first lacquered, but in the 14th century, lacquering was replaced again with silk lacing. Instead, because the lacquering process was extremely labor-intensive, lacquering took an enormous amount of effort, patience, and a lot of money to make. Lacquering also provided the additional benefit of waterproofing the armor. In the 16th century, from 1543 to 1614, also known as the Nanban trade, Japan and Europe began trading, and Japanese armor continued to improve as matchlock muskets were traded from Portugal. Due to these muskets, samurai continued to improve their armor to be resistant to those same muskets that were now new to their land. Shortly after, bullet-resistant sets of armor were created called bullet-tested, or tameshi gusoku, which allowed for increased protection against firearms. As a result of this, the kusoku, or modern armor style, appeared. As Japan entered into the more peaceful Edo period, samurai continued to use plate and lamellar armor. Lightweight portable armor became popular because although wars were not common during this Edo period, individuals still needed protection. Peasant revolts, assassinations, and duels were still common in Japan during the Edo period, and as a result of this, the kusari, katabari, or chain armor became popular because they could be easily worn under their ordinary clothing. Armor continued to evolve and change depending on the materials available to the samurai class until the end of the samurai class when the Meiji era began in 1868. We upload new videos every week, so subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to hit the like button as well. Click the notification bell to be notified of when we upload these videos. See you on the next episode of Culture Screen.